Hello viewers, I welcome you all to the video lecture series of Uttarakhand Open University. I, Dr. Manjri Agarwal, is taking a lecture on accounting and finance for managers. This is course for their CT1001. This paper or course is in the first semester for MBA students, and also this topic of working capital, which I am taking this lecture, is also applicable for corporate finance course for MBA first semester. So today we will be taking this working capital management, which is in block 4 and unit is 21. Now in this lecture we will be taking or we will be discussing working capital concepts, working capital issues or the issues pertaining to working capital, financing current asset, which is divided into short term and long term debt, and fourth, combining liability structure and the combination of current asset and the current liability which is required in the company. Now after reading this unit, you will be able to explain and define the meaning of working capital, assess the importance of working capital. You will be able to find out what is the relationship between various components of working capital in the company, identify the factors which affect working capital decisions. You will be able to estimate the amount of working capital which is required by a company at a certain point of time. You will be able to comprehend the financial planning and management of working capital. Last but not the least, you will be conversant with estimating firm's working capital using operating cycles. Now let us start. What is this working capital is all about? As you know that the financial management functions or decisions are divided into two aspects. One is long-term investment, decisions regarding long-term investment. The other is decisions regarding short-term. You have already read about long-term investment decision in block 2, that is in capital budgeting and capital structure. Now, the other aspect, that is short-term asset, is taken care of in this lecture. What is this short-term asset and what are various important aspects which is to be dealt by a finance manager? As you know that working capital, as I said, that it is regarding short-term investment. So, it basically denotes the liquidity position of a company. Working capital is that amount of capital which is required by a company for day-to-day functioning. Or, you can say in other words, working capital is that amount of funds which is required by the company for daily working, for operations day-to-day, without any interruptions or intrusions. One can say that working capital management is a vital decision in respect to the liquidity and profitability aspect. So working capital can basically said, working capital management can be said as the process in which planning, organizing, monitoring and controlling of short-term assets are being done, and even we take into account the financing pattern which a company should adopt for financing these current assets. Now, coming to the decisions of working, the definitions regarding working capital, the definitions are basically given by different authors. There are different formulations by different authors. But overall, the two concepts emerge from the definition of working capital. In this slide, I am taking two different definitions, which is first is being given by Van Horn and the second is by Ross. So the first one is the working capital refers to the administration of firm's current assets, namely cash and marketable securities, receivables and inventory, and financing especially current liabilities needed to support current assets. Whereas the other definition which is given by Ross, Westerfield and Jordan is the term working capital refers to a firm's short-term assets such as inventory and its short-term liabilities such as money owed to suppliers. Now, after going through or reading this definition, two concepts emerges. One is gross working capital. The other is net working capital. Now, gross working capital is the amount of funds in short-term assets. That is, amount of the funds which is clocked in short-term assets of a company. Whereas, net working capital is the difference between current assets and current liabilities. Here, we not only study how to optimize the liquidity and profitability through the current assets and current liabilities, rather, we also find the interrelation between these two. In case of gross working capital, we try to trade off between excessive investment in current assets and inadequate investment in current assets. But the reason is why one has to trade off between these two extreme views. The point is, if you invest greater amount in current assets, it will impair profitability of a concern. That is, you have to forego the profit which you could have earned if you invest this fund in some other avenues of investment or in other investment vehicles. Now the point is, in case of inadequate investment in current assets, there will be problem with the solvency of a company. That is, you will have problem of liquidity. And hence, company can face cash crunch even in the time of robust growth. Therefore, in this point of view of gross working capital, you have to trade off between excessive investment in current assets and inadequate investment in current assets. Now, in the other concept of net working capital, that is difference between current assets and current liability, if this difference is positive, then we say that working capital of a company is having a positive, on the positive side, that is, company is having positive working capital. Now, on the other hand, if company is having negative working capital, traditionally said, if company is having problem with the liquidity or company is facing cash crunch. But again, I should here emphasize or advise you that traditionally it is said the company should not have negative working capital. But nowadays, we have seen the number of companies, especially as you quote Amazon.com and Dabur, where even with having negative working capital, they are quite excessive. Therefore, this positive or negative working capital depends on the company situation, the various factors which affect company. Now, coming to the need and significance. The need and significance of working capital can be judged by a statement that many of the companies have failed because of mismanagement of working capital. And past, there is so many examples of companies which we can quote in terms that because of mismanagement of working capital, because of either having excessive or inadequate of working capital, company has viewed and they have seen that they have geared losses also. So therefore, working capital is a lifeblood of a business. It can be said as a lifetime of a business. And because of this working capital, company can even come to the threat of insolvency. Therefore, a finance manager has to balance regarding what should be the right amount, the optimum amount of working capital in a company. Now, in this case, regarding the work, what should be the proportion of current assets and current liabilities in the company, or what should be the optimum level of working capital of company, two aspects are taken into account. One is the proportion or the composition of working capital. The other is financing part. So composition in itself means that what is the proportion between current assets and current liabilities, and regarding financing, which financing mode should be opted by a company to finance its current asset or short-term asset. We will be taking these two aspects in later in the slide, but right now the needs and of working capital can easily be assessed on the basis of these two aspects, and various factors are there which affect these two components or aspects of working capital requirement in the company. Now coming to the types of working capital. The first type, there are two types basically. The first one is permanent working capital or fixed working capital. The other is variable or fluctuating working capital. Permanent working capital is that amount of working capital or a minimum amount of capital which is required for a company to support its day-to-day functioning or to for the daily operation or for operating the company. That is, in spite of whatever the level of production it is, this much amount of company should have in order to function effectively. On the other hand, variable or fluctuating working capital is that amount of working capital which fluctuates, which varies according to the level of production or sale. That is, this amount of capital is over and above or additional of permanent working capital, which depends or which fluctuates on the level of basically on the level of production or sale or demand. Now, as you will come across this graph, in which you can see that even permanent current assets is also increasing as the time progresses. Point is, even permanent or fixed working capital, it can also increase, but it increases with a big rate. Whereas, as you can see, there is a lot of fluctuations in temporary current assets, and this depends on the increment or decrement of production or sales or demand. Therefore, this how much portion of company should keep in permanent current asset or temporary current asset depends on the structure of the company, size of the company, the industry in which the company operates. Now, coming to the components of working capital. Components of working capital. Are of two types. One is current assets . The other is current liabilities. So current assets and current liabilities. Current assets are those assets which can be converted into cash in a time of 1 year or in one operating cycle. Now I use the word operating cycle. In the next slides, we will be covering this portion also. What is this operating cycle? But at this point of time, you can just remember that current assets are those assets or that part of assets which can be easily converted into cash in a period of 1 year. Current liabilities are those short-term obligations which a company has to fulfill, a company has to pay in a duration of 1 year. So, there are various parts of these current assets and current liabilities which overall contribute in assessing working capital. So, in case of current assets, the parts are inventory, that is stock, and this stock is subdivided into three parts. One, stock of raw material, stock of finished good, and stock of work in progress. The second is sundry debtors, bill receivables, cash and bank balances in your current account, in savings account, marketable securities, loan and advances, and prepaid expenses. Now, current liabilities, the components of current liabilities are acceptances, sundry creditors, bills payable, income received in advance, unclaimed dividend warrants, unclaimed debenture interest warrants, application money refundable, interest accrued but not due on loans, short-term loans and advances, cash credits from banks, bank overdrafts, provisions and this table which I also given in the second. So, if I just want explaining in much detail, let's suppose a company X have 10,000 in inventory, rupees 10,000 in inventory, in bills payable, bills receivable, that's 5,000, and in debtors have 15,000.
Equation. The first equation is that raw material conversion period
the work in progress conversion period, the fixed goods conversion period is equal to production cycle. Second is, when we add receivable conversion period also to this production cycle, we have gross operating cycle. Now further, in third step, if we deduct average payables period from gross operating cycle, you will have a resulting of net operating cycle. Further, when you exclude depreciation from expenses for calculating this entire net operating cycle, you will have cash conversion cycle. So through these three steps, you will ultimately come to cash conversion cycle. And it is said that operating cycle have inverse proportion to cash conversion cycle. That means the shorter would be operating cycle, the faster would be transformation of sales into cash, and it will contribute a positive aspect for a company. So, in this operating cycle, you will be able to find out that how much amount of current assets or current liabilities a company should have a particular point of time. Current assets should always be greater than current liabilities. Why? That is, for a rupee of obligation, for 1 rupee of obligation which you have to pay to the creditors, you should have twice the amount in current assets. So, traditionally, and in general, or in conventional rule, as per conventional rule, idle ratio between current assets and current liabilities, it should be 2:1. That is, little bit of a company should be having a conservative policy in keeping 2:1 ratio, that for 1 rupee, company is having 2 rupees for in current assets. And one more idle ratio is in respect to quick ratio. That is, quick ratio is equal to current assets minus inventory. And this quick asset is to current liabilities should be equal to current liability. That is, 1:1 ratio should be there in case of quick ratio. Now again I am stating that it is a conventional approach. On an average, generally we follow this approach while estimating working capital. But I will now coin two terms, that is negative working capital and zero working capital, and which is also being followed in present scenario. Now coming to the next slide, that is trade-off between liquidity and profitability. I also use this term in between number of slides, that liquidity and profitability should be traded off by a finance manager or in the financial management decisions. Now what is this liquidity? Now let's suppose you are running a manufacturing firm. You have to keep a certain amount of funds for production, and also you will keep a decent amount as a buffer to support any unforeseen contingencies or unforeseen fluctuations in demand or supply, or even you have to keep a buffer against inflationary pressure. So therefore, you will have to keep a decent amount of the funds in inventory or in current assets. Therefore, the point is that I also explained in the previous slide that the company has to trade off between excessive and necessary investments in current assets. Now, if you invest greater amount in current assets, you have to forego profits which you could have earned. Whereas, if you will keep lesser amount of working capital than required, company will save cash funds or will have to bear the threat of insolvency. Therefore, these two extremes of liquidity and profitability should be traded off. That is, finance managers have to optimize between liquidity and profitability. You are also seeing this graph, which I am taking from Financial Management by Pandey. Now, in this graph, you can see that as the current assets progresses, as the amount of current assets progresses, cost of equity decreases. Whereas cost of liquidity increases. That is, on the one hand, as you increase the current asset, liquidity of the concern no doubt will increase, but company has to forego that interest which it can earn in when it could have invested into bank or some other investment vehicles. So therefore, you have to optimize between these two costs, and you have to keep this a minimum cost so that the company can have profit. On the contrary, the liquidity with having a liquidity in the concern. Now there are two aspects which I took. One is the proportion or the composition of working capital. The other part was financing. The composition I said also what should be the proportion between current asset and current liabilities. There are a number of factors which affect that, and on the forthcoming slides we will take into account. But right now the other aspect, that is financing aspect of working capital of current asset. There are basically different policies vis-a-vis current assets. First is long-term financing. That is, you finance through preference shares, through equity share capital, or through debentures or long-term loans. The second view is short-term financing. That is, for the shorter duration, you raise loans or advances, and it could be in form of bank overdrafts, it could be in form of commercial papers, or factoring of receivables. Last is spontaneous financing, that is trade credit and outstanding expenses are the quite good examples of spontaneous financing. And company resolved to these three financing in for its working capital in FPO. Now, these three financing aspects or methodologies result in three different approaches which company adopt time to time. Or company adopt an approach forever, depending upon the situation of the company, depending on the management attitude, the size of the company, the mentality of shareholders and board of directors. So these three approaches are matching approach or hedging approach, conservative approach and aggressive approach. Now taking the first aspect, matching approach. In matching approach, as you can see in the graph, that the permanent current asset and fixed asset, which are quite company is aware of how much would be required, is financed long-term financing. Whereas temporary or fluctuating working capital or current asset is financed from short-term financing. That is, expected amount of duration of the asset is matched with expected amount of duration of the loans and advances. The second is conservative approach. In this approach, company is little bit having precaution, and that is why company is financing its permanent current assets, fixed assets, and little bit part of temporary current assets from long-term financing. And part of portion of temporary current asset is financed from short-term financing. That is aggressive approach. In this approach, permanent current assets and fixed assets. The part is bifurcated. Fixed assets and part of permanent current assets is financed long-term financing. And company desires to take a risk, it can finance temporary current assets and part of even permanent current assets from short-term financing. So companies have an aggressive approach in long-term assets.